I decided to build my own puppet animatronic VTuber. It moves when I move, it talks when I talk. Hello, my name is Edrim, and I want to show you how this whole setup works. For those that don't know, VTuber stands for Virtual YouTuber, which is a terrible description because most VTubers actually use other websites like Twitch now. So the best way to describe it is a person's virtual avatar, which is also terrible because I'm physical. Now, I wanted to try out being a VTuber, but there is a problem. Many VTubers can cost hundreds, if not thousands of dollars to make, which I don't have. And the cheaper, more generic ones need a bit of skill in 3D modeling programs to really make unique. Skills I also don't have, but what I do have is enough knowledge in electronics and sewing and coding to make a puppet, so I set out to see if I could make it work. The first step was designing the parts to be 3D printed. This was trial and horrible error, but eventually I got something that kind of worked. From there I had to actually make the puppet, which is surprisingly simple thanks to a lot of YouTube videos out there. It didn't stop me from screwing it up though, which is why I tried to hide my weird chin with camera angles. From there, I ordered the cheapest motors I could find from AliExpress, which should hopefully work just fine, and connected everything up. And now we have working movement if we manually adjust the motors. But we don't want to do that. We want it to track our face. So for that, we turn over to VTuber software. VC Face is a very good 3D VTuber software that many people out there use, but I was really interested in the face tracking part. Luckily, the developer has made this available as its own little software package called OpenC Face, so I can just use that and not anything else. This takes the video from my webcam, a nice little Logitech C92, and figures out where all the bits of my face are. Only problem is this face tracking is actually pretty heavy on my computer, and we want to be gaming and streaming and not getting any stutters in those terribly optimized PC games companies keep putting out. So to fix this, I've got the face tracking running on a little mini computer instead called an Orange Pi. It's a tiny little 10-watt USB-powered computer and somehow still manages to churn out face tracking information 30 times a second. And it, of course, can play Doom. And all that face information gets sent to my shed. Yes, the puppet is in the shed out the back because servo motors are loud and the people who I live with would murder me in my sleep if they had to listen to this all night long. By the way, the dumbbell in this picture is actually structurally necessary. I never said this was a well-designed animatronic. It can topple over without that. In the shed is a laptop that is running my own absolutely cursed Python code that takes human face tracking movements and converts it to puppet movements. This puppet part's positional payload is then sent to a microcontroller board called an Arduino. Really cool little thing that lets you control all kinds of electronics with. This has even more of my cursed code that lets it directly control the puppet servo motors. There are 5 motors currently on the puppet, one at the base that controls yaw, one in the neck that controls pitch, one motor for each lip that work together, and can't get it to work properly, so it's kind of just their motor in the base that also controls pitch. I'd also like to add a motor to do roll movements in the future, as well as animatronic eyes, maybe some LEDs, flamethrower. Fun fact, jammed motors can get so hot they start to melt the 3D printed plastic around them. They can also start spinning endlessly when their power supply gets a bit iffy, tearing all the wires out. Those are fun days. I've duct taped a heatsink I had sitting around to one of the servos, but surprise, surprise, those cheap AliExpress motors just constantly died on me, and eventually I had to bite the bullet and spend more on some proper servo motors, which also died on me, but at least they lasted a bit longer. Back to the puppet. In front of that, we have a Sony A5100 camera, which sends the video from the shed to my room with a stupidly long HDMI cable. Once that video feed gets sent to my computer, it goes into OBS. We apply some green screening, sharpen the image a bit, composite it into the scene, and then we are good to go. And that's how my animatronic puppet VTuber works. And if you'd like to see more, I'm live over on twitch.tv/edrim almost every night, playing games and having fun with the occasional coding stream. And if you'd like to follow along and see the puppet improve over time, that'll be the best place to do it. You can also like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube, as I'll be making more videos about upgrading the puppet and other weird projects I'm working on in the future. Alright, bye!